In this video, I'd like to show you a really cool method of creating moldings in your visualizations. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, my name is Aga and I'm a CG artist. And on this channel, we explore techniques and tools that will help you become a better artist. Today, we'll create some ornaments on the wall. But before we start, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, so you are sure you don't miss any future tutorials. Okay, let's jump to 3ds Max. This is our example scene. Let me isolate the walls so it's easier to work on this. First of all, we need to have a shape that we'll use, so I will select the edges and create a shape from it. And now, I will use the Sweep Profile plugin from Case Studio. I put the link in the description below the video so you can check it out. You can see that I have different types of moldings here. I like this one. To make it work, we need to have the line selected and we need to double click on the example we want to use. Here we go. It's not in the right position though. That's not the problem, as we can easily fix it by choosing the pivot alignment here. We can also use the mirror option if needed. It's cool, isn't it? But it's not everything. We can also change the size. We are able to control length and width. Plus, we can change the interpolation. The model will be more or less dense. And we have some options for smoothing as well. You can notice that the sweep modifier is automatically created on top of the spline. We can modify it from this level as well. Okay, let's create the other ones. The process will be the same. We need to create shapes first. I will create a spline from the edges between the wall and ceiling as well. Now let's create a nice profile that we can use. Maybe this one. Double click on it. We need to align the pivot. And let's adjust the size. It's nice, isn't it? And let's choose something else for the top one. You can see that there are lots of options to choose from, but you need to buy these sets from their website. You can purchase them separately or in a bundle. Anyways, I like this one. Again, I'll double click and adjust the pivot. Here we go. The next step will be the size. Let's make it bigger. Cool, I like it. Now we'll create the rectangle shape ornaments. Uncheck the Start New Shape option and select the Auto Create option. Draw the rectangles. So everything that we draw now will be created as one spline. The same for the bottom. And on this side as well. Let's choose the profiles now. I'll pick this one. Again, I need to align the pivot. You can see that the profiles work differently on the side. No problem, we can simply detach it and create a new profile for this. But first, let's adjust the existing profiles. I will decrease the width. and also we don't need so dense model. Let's decrease the section interpolation. Now we can simply copy the sweep modifier and adjust it on the side of the wall. Here we go. Now let's create one more ornament inside these ones. Select the lines and use the outline option. Ctrl plus I and detach the selection. Select the line and choose the profile. We'll adjust the pivot again. I would like it to be a bit wider. And now we'll do the same for the other side of the wall. As before, we can simply copy and paste the sweep modifier. Now let me show you one more cool thing about this plugin. You can create your own profiles. I imported a model so I can quickly show you the process. I will take a spline from this. I will delete the polygons and create a shape from the edges. Now click the sweep profile icon. Choose the category. Now remember that we need to have a pivot of the spline in the correct place and it needs to be positioned horizontally. So we need to see it in the top view. I will reset X-Form to be sure we don't have any issue with the scale. Collapse all. Now select the profile and click Add to Library. You can see that it automatically created the preview for this. What a cool option, isn't it? Here is how it looks in the library. And now, we can use it the same way we did for the ready profiles. Let me show you. We can choose this line, for example. And here it is. So not only you can use ready profiles from the Case Studio website, but also you can add your own ones and grow your library even more. This way, we can really speed up our workflow, especially if we create lots of spaces like this one. Also, if you'd like to know my process of creating images from start to finish, I'd like to invite you to check out our visualization training. Click here to check it out on our website. Bye!